Here they are in their national TV debut to sing their hit song, Makes Me Wanna Sing, Stryper! To mention, in case you didn't see what they were throwing, these are new copies of the New Testament that they were throwing out with the little insignia Stryper on it. Now, this kind of music is being played all over America in clubs and concert halls. There's even a whole TV show devoted to gospel rock.
And the host of that show may come as a surprise to you. Let's bring him out right now, one of America's top recording artists, Mr. Pat Boone.
Now we're back with Pat Boone and Stryper's drummer Robert Sweet. Now I understand that you've got an upcoming tour now with the Motley Crue. You're calling the Heaven and Hell Tour?
Well, we don't actually have a tour right now with Motley Crue, but there was a rock magazine that printed the statement, wouldn't it be neat to see something like that? You know, the good versus evil, the kind of boxing match in the rock and roll arena between, say, someone like Motley Crue and Stryper, because we're the only ones out right now that are doing what we're doing.
Uh-huh. Do you think it'll happen?
Oh, there's a good possibility of it happening.
Oh, okay.
You know why? Because kids today, and people in the record business too, are so into any kind of shock, any kind of new sensation, that it hardly matters what it is, good, bad, or what. Mm-hmm. And so to put the two together sounds, hey, yeah, you know, maybe there can be fistfights will break out in the audience, or, you know, who knows what. It'll be wild. That's all, wild. If it's wild and crazy and a sensory blitz, then let's do it.
Yeah. Well, I know one thing. We wouldn't want to see fistfights break out.
No,
that's
no,
true.
You wouldn't. You wouldn't.
Me either. But absolutely not. But McLean's got someone out there in the audience with a question, don't you, McLean?
I've got some someones, we hope.
Okay.
And this nice lady, if you'd stand and give us your name and direct your question, please.
My name is Lois, And Pat, my question to you is that in seeing this group perform with their stage setting and the loudness of their sound, it almost appears that the word of God is lost and the spotlight is on the performance rather than on God. And how do you work with that?
Well, let me even quote Jesus. The reason he performed miracles, he said, if you don't believe me for what I say, believe me for what I do. And any great preacher, whether it's Billy Graham or Jimmy Swaggart or any preacher you can think of, stood up anywhere where a lot of these kids that love rock music are, they're not going to hear what he says. But they're gonna look at them, they're going to hear what they say. Here they were putting the lyrics on the screen, which is great, so you know that what they're singing. Kids are geared these days to digging for the words. First they want to hear the sound, and they want to see the look, and they want to get the impact of who they are and what image they're projecting. But then they dig for the words, you can bank on that. And of course the lyrics in today's music is a key concern, I mean even a congressional concern now. And rightly so, because it's sadomasochistic and brutal and every kind of thing. So these guys, they get their attention first, and then they say, we're saying something, and the kids say, what is it? What are they saying? What are they saying? Mm-hmm. They dig for the message, and the message there.
Now, Pat, your show. He's going on the road. I think this lady has just one more minute of time here. She had something she wanted to say. I think we should give it back to her.
Oh, it is only that we are certainly challenged by God to celebrate.
Mm-hmm.
And this is according to the old...
People can really understand what you're trying to say when they can relate to you. And kids in rock and roll today, they relate with the image of rock and roll. They understand that. And when you can get on stage and look like what they want to come and see and put out that message, they'll listen to you a lot more. We throw Bibles in the audience. We stand up when there's no music going on and make a bold, bold statement that the reason we're here is to tell God's side of the story in rock and roll.